Hey guys, so this video, actually the topic of this video is kind of a long time coming. I wanted to talk about this topic for a long time, and I finally got around to recording myself. So I had a lot of ideas when I wanted to start talking about this, and a lot of those ideas got lost in the shuffle now. But the main point is, I really feel nostalgic to the older version of YouTube. And I don't mean like the previous version or the previous version, but I mean like a much older version of YouTube, like 2 years ago, or a year and a half ago, or a year ago. I'm not exactly sure when it was that the YouTube version was the version that I was like, this, I love this YouTube. And then it changed, I'm just like, What happened? What happened to this feature that was really cool? Like, why? You know, my guess on the change, I feel like I'll be right, is because of bandwidth, just to make the site go smoother and faster, and the pages load faster, and the videos go faster, whatever. I think that's probably why things have changed to be the way they are. I actually, you know, a lot of people, when they get used to a website, you know, and the administrators, they change it. They give a new updated version, you know, version 2.0, 2.1, 3.1. They update the version. And the initial response of a lot of people is like, what the fuck is this? What just happened? I hate this. This blows, man. Change it back right now. That happens, you know. And when I think one of the cool things that YouTube has done with this changes is kind of up, you know, make a beta version and have people test it out, and eventually that beta version becomes the whole YouTube. And the past couple of iterations of YouTube changes have been implemented that way. And I think that's why it's been rather a smooth transition. And there's great amount of features that were added, you know, a lot of changes that happened that I think are really pretty cool. I can't really name specific ones. Like, the one I can name is that you can click on any part of the video and it'll skip to it. But that was an old change. Before, if you remember, YouTube, like many other streaming sites, you click play on the video and it plays the video. And unless you hit pause and you waited for all that data to stream and load, you couldn't fast forward to that part of the video. Now, You click on a video link, you start the video, and you're like, you know what, I want to skip to the 30 minute of this hour long video. You do that, and it goes right there. It hasn't always been that way. And I think that's amazing. That's a great technological advancement. It's a great improvement in the interface of how we view YouTube. And YouTube has been like so influential now. Like, some of my college classes as a graduate student, some of my professors use YouTube videos in their lectures. Like, that just goes over my head, like, whoa, what kind of change is this? In my high school that I'm an intern at, some of the teachers I have done, like, classroom observations, some of them use their iPad, go on YouTube, and that's part of their lesson plan. That's part of their teaching instruction. It's crazy, like, how much YouTube has seeped into our culture that is even used in classroom settings. You know, and I think that's amazing, the reach of YouTube. But one thing that I'm really nostalgic about in regards to YouTube, and I really miss the older version of YouTube, and it doesn't really exist anymore, or if it does and I just don't know how to make it work, is that YouTube used to be really friendly for like archival purposes. So if any of you guys remember the older versions of YouTube, you could click on the video and, you know, the video will be showing like it is right here. And on the top of it, there were these, like, on top of that video are these other thumbnails of videos that you could click on. And those videos are the videos that this user has uploaded, right? And there are, depending on the date, so if this is the most recent video, then the thumbnails are like the past couple of videos that the user has uploaded. Which is great, because if you like what this, if you clicked on the video randomly, somehow you got there, and you're like, oh, this user made really cool video, I wonder what he uploaded a day ago or a week ago. Boom! You just go right there. you know, great for archival purposes. And you can also go to the user's channel, and you're like, I wonder what that person's very first video was. You know, and it's easy. It's very easy to do that in the older version of YouTube. Now, it's a bit more difficult. You have to kind of click through filters. But let's say this. That can still be done in this version of YouTube. But what's really difficult is a situation like this. Let's say this YouTube user uploaded several videos in this one playlist, right? And so you click on a video of that playlist, you watch that video, now you want to watch the next part. This YouTube version that we are using, this interface we're using, makes that kind of difficult. You have to search out the playlist somehow. But in the older version, you could just, the next video in the playlist is right there, right below, or I think it was above, yeah, right above the video. It's the next, there's rows of next videos to watch, and there's rows of previous videos to watch. Like if you're watching part 5 and you want to watch part 4, you just click the arrow and you, it's there. Like the playlist, I could make a playlist and it's archived. People can easily access the playlist in that way. And that's why for me it was very helpful to make playlists and put videos in there. That was really great. Also, this new version of YouTube, newer versions of YouTube, makes it hard to archive at all. So I make a playlist, right? In the older version, I put a video in that playlist, and I could decide the order by putting a number. Like if I have 30 videos and I want this to be like the 15th video in this list, I just type 15 on this, click enter, and it becomes the 15th video. That number system is now gone. If I want that video to be the 15th video, I have to hold on it, you know, click, put my pointer over it, hold the mouse button, and drag it slowly down, down, down to the 15th position. I don't know what, like, typing in the number is so much more efficient and so much easier than doing that. But that's, you know, it's more laborious to do it this way, but whatever. The filter system's improved, but how YouTube has changed the way I see it philosophically now is everything is now. It's kind of like the App Store that you have on your iPad or iPhone, or the Android Store on your Droid phone. You know, you go to the store and it's like, what is featured now? What's most popular now? What's the best app now? YouTube is kind of like that now. You know, you go to, you watch a video and it's just like, these are similar to it. These are similar videos, recommended videos. These are featured videos. But you can never really kind of just explore more about the user that uploaded that video. You can't really, it takes much more effort on your part to go to the archives of that person's video. For example, you'll notice that I have so many videos on this channel. This is like my 1500th video, like 1500 video. I don't know how many videos I've made. I've done a lot for whatever reason. Most of them are on video games, so they're not really, I don't know, whatever. But like, even so, I sometimes just like the fact that people can, or I can, just kind of click on like my interest topics and go there and watch it. It's much harder now. And I think that's really disappointing that YouTube could be this great resource. Like, it's this stuff that's just archived and archived and archived. Like, the one thing that made me really disappointed was when I went to this really popular channel, the Young Turks Network. You know, I went on there and I was just like, man, I wonder, like, what the videos they made in, like, 2009, what they were like. And in the older version of YouTube, that was very easy to do, to get to the 2009 video. But I found myself like trying to dig and get to there, and it was just like, I kind of give up. I'm just gonna watch some of the older stuff and that call it a day. It's really disappointing to me how the philosophy of the YouTube interface has changed, so that the older archive stuff, it's really, YouTube really is very user unfriendly for archival purposes now. Yeah. So I hope somehow, eventually, maybe it's a bandwidth issue that they could do that. I don't know. Maybe it just doesn't generate them enough ad revenue to implement that back. But I would like it back. I think it was a really great feature to be able to just archive videos and to access archived videos easily. Because I don't really... It's to me, it's not always about, you know, my subscription fee. You know, YouTube is something that I generally like to access all these videos that people like myself, regular people, have, you know, produced and recorded and put it up there. Now YouTube has become such a big thing that there's production companies that go behind it. Like, some channels have budgets that are insanely ridiculous because they actually make so much profit off of it. But, you know, I just like YouTube when I could check out a YouTube user and end up just delving into that YouTube user's kind of video blogging sharing life, you know?